Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Julien Delplanque, and today I'm going to talk about the future of testing in Faro, which will be materialized as Dr. Test architecture. So first, a word about the developers that contributed to this project, because it's not only my work. So I'm on the left, I'm Julien Delplanque, I'm a PhD student in Hermod team. I'm in last year of PhD, and I'm hacking Faro around many aspects. So you might have encountered me on the Discord, or no, I think it's on GitHub, but this one. And so I was hit by a testing topic a bit by accident during a Faro sprint. And the second person that is working on the testing infrastructure of Faro is Dainé. She's been working for the last 6 months as a GSOC student and as an intern in Hermod team. So let's go into the topic. So I'm going to talk about the testing infrastructure of Faro. And to start, we are going to have a look at the SUnit test runner and some of its limitations and the limitations that are under the implementation of SUnit test runner. Then I'll present you Dr. Test, which is an architecture to build tools around test, and I'll talk a little about the internals of Dr. Test, and I'll finish by the next step of this project. So, first of all, for Faroers, this UI should be well known because this is how the test infrastructure is exposed from the user interface point of view to users. So it's quite easy. You have the package which contain tests, you have the test case, you can select them, and then you can either run the test, compute the profile the test execution, or compute the coverage of those tests. Okay, and then you can visualize the result on the right. But with tests, you can actually do more than running them, profiling their execution, or analyzing the code coverage. Actually, you can do a lot of things. So the three first things that are supported by the test runner are at the top, so running the test, profiling, computing coverage. But since Faro 8, we also have parametrizable tests, which are tests for which there are parameters, and so you have a parameter matrix. And so you can run the same test with multiple parameters and eventually get different outputs. We have an implementation of mutation testing. Mutation testing is a framework that will modify the code that is tested by your test and check that after each mutation, your test fails. Because if your test does not fail when you introduce an error in the code, it means that your test is not that good. So this provides a metric of the robustness of your test. We have rotten green tests. So those are tests that contains assertion that you can see in the code, but they are not executed at the runtime. So there is a talk later during the conference about them. You should check it out. And finally, in Faro, we have executable commands, which are some kind of assertion that you can put in the source code with an example of like a code snippet, which is an example, and the expected outcome. And so you would like to check that all your executable commands in your commands are still valid, because if they are not, you either need to fix the command or to fix your code. And there are many more analyses. So we are starting to have quite an ecosystem around test in Faro. And we realized that the test runner UI and the model handler does not scale, because here, okay, you could add even more buttons each time, but it will not scale. Like, there is a problem, obviously. So a word about the test runner model. So I'm talking about the test runner UI. There is kind of no model behind, so there is no object with which you can interact. You have to directly deal with the UI. So we think it's a problem with the SUnit test runner UI. So, to summarize, what do we want? We'd like to power up testing experiments in Faro around three aspects. First, we'd like to let people plug their custom analysis in the testing architecture. We'd like for that to provide a good model to configure, run, and gather the results from the plugin. And a third step is that we would like to let people customize the way the results are visualized by the user. For example, you would like to sort them according to your needs. And so Some analysis might require differing visualization from others, so you need to have this part, the customization of result visualization is an important part. So to answer these requirements, we developed Doctor Test, and this is the UI that exposes Doctor Test to the user. So we try to keep it kind of similar to SUnitRunner to not get people lost. So at the left, on the left part of the UI, you can still see that you have the package and the test case to select in order to run the test runner. But the test runner is now only a plugin of Doctor Test. It's not the main feature of the UI. So depending on the plugin, you will have different possibility of input on the left of the UI. For example, for the test coverage, you will not have the same input as for the test runner, but I will show after in the demo. On the right part of the UI, you still have the results. The difference that now you are able to add, so we want plugin to be able to plug custom actions that are runnable on the result. And so this is made via a contextual menu. And we want to be able to change the result view via the drop list that is at the top. And so at the bottom, you are able to run the run Doctor Test. So before the demo, I'd like to insist on the fact that with Doctor Test, people developing plugins for the testing structure will have the full control on the UI. So here, the plugin are able to control the red and orange part of the screen, depending on the part of the architecture that you implement. So the red part is managed by the plugin, and the orange part is managed by the result object. So it's you that have the control. Okay, so I'll switch to the demo. So, are the front okay? Yeah, okay. Okay, so in this image, I replaced the SUnitRunner by Doctor Test, so you can access it exactly as you were accessing SUnitRunner. And so you can see here that we provide built-in a list of different plugins that are available to analyze your test. So you have the test runner, coverage profiler as the SUnitRunner, and additionally, you can check your executable commands and find rotten grain tests in your test. So let's show it works with the test runner. So for example, if I start, if I run the test on the ESTCore package, I will see that everything is working. And on the right side of the UI, you can see that now the results are displayed as a tree. So we choose the tree because it's super flexible to visualize data. And so here, a new feature that provides Doctor Test is that you can rerun only, so of course you can browse a test, so you browse one and insert a failure just to show, okay. And a new feature of Doctor Test is that you can rerun any part, any subtree in this tree. So if I take, for example, here, I rerun the test, it will rerun only the free test. And so here you can see that the test that I made fail is still failing. To debug the test, you just run it via the debug command, and so you get the test that will pop a debugger in order to let people fix it. Okay, and so I can rerun it. Okay, so I was talking about the fact that you can visualize the test in multiple ways. So this can be done via this drop list. And so, for example, here, I visualize the test in a similar way that SUnitRunner, but you can build a tree on multiple levels. For example, with the third visualization, you will build it on result, class, and then protocol. And so if you look in the pacing test, they are sorted by class, and then protocols, and then you have the test, which can be quite useful when you are searching for something in your test. So let's have a look at another plugin. So for example, the test coverage plugin. here you can see that the left and the middle list do not contain exactly the same as in the test runner. On the left list, you still have the packages containing tests, but on the right list, you have to specify the package for which you want to compute the coverage. So, for example, for the announcements, you will compute the coverage of the announcement score test package on announcement score. And so if you run the coverage, you will get the result here with the percentage of code coverage for the package you selected, and then the uncovered method that you can browse, and then you can add tests to increase the coverage. For the profiler, I don't know if you remember for those using SUnitRunner, but the data displayed by the profiler, it is like a text dump. It's not really obvious what it is. So we wanted to provide more explicit data. So here first, we have the test group by type of result and then test run. And so you can see the time took by each test. But normally, when you are running the profiler, your test should pass, because else the profiling is not really meaningful. Yeah, maybe it was. And so here, we added another way to visualize the result that allows to watch the time took per test case to run. And then you can look into details to find the bottleneck in your code and so on. Okay, but let's have a look at something a bit different that we are able to plug in Doctor Test. So in Faro, we have executable code comments. So I will show you some that we have. Okay. So here, for example, I will show you what it looks like first. Okay. So here, this is a comment. So because you can see the double quotes on each side, but this is an executable comment inside the comment. So it means that this part, you can execute it, and it works kind of as an assertion. The left part should be equal to the right part, and it provides a concise and handy way to show to the user how to use a method. So we think it's quite cool for when you need to discover an API. But for now, we had no way, well, at least no integrated way, to check that all the examples in the comments were still right in the image. And so we implemented a plugin that does that in Doctor Test, and we are now able to explore them and to fix the ones that are failures. And so you can see that there are some that are failures because we are not checking for them. Okay, so let's go back to the presentation, if I can find it. Okay, so what I just show you was the UI that exposed Doctor Test, but in fact, it's not really important. What is really important is the model that we created under the UI, because we wanted a model that allows people to plug their analysis. And so to do that, we have three main parts in the model. We have object that models the configuration to run an analysis, and they can be created either via UI or by scripting. So this should be for the test runner, the test case to run, or for the executable comment checker, the comments that you want to execute. Then you have the plugin part, which defines, according to a configuration, how to run this configuration. And it also provides some updates through announcements. And it returns a result. Then the result, again, can be either queried by from the UI or by scripting. So, as a first consequence of using a model under the UI for Doctor Test and for the testing infrastructure, is that you can easily expose plugins via different UI. And so we did a small experiment. We created Mini Doctor Test, which is a UI which can be accessed via the switch button, which is at the top right of Doctor Test. And this UI aims to be just a big button that once you choose your configuration, you can just press it each time you did a modification on your source code to check that everything is still right. And so this UI just provides a quick visual feedback, but it's just via the colors. And so while it's green, you can continue to press the button and to code, But when it's red, you can switch back to maxi doctor test. So I can show quickly the UI. So the plugin can define if they want to be minifiable or not via doctor test. So some plugins are not minifiable because we did not find yet a way to synthesize the information. And so here, okay, you get the mini doctor test. And so you can stick it on the part of the screen, and so you edit your code and you rerun the test each time. Okay. So a word on the API. So how do you create a new plugin? You have to basically implement three classes that will subclass some classes provided by the doctor test. The first one is the configuration. The goal of this object is to store the data that are required for the plugin to run correctly on some input. So those are the input of the plugin. So for a test runner, for example, it will be just the list of tests that needs to be executed. Then you need to actually implement the plugin. And so the plugin is the big part because it controls quite a lot of things. It can control the labels, the content of the list, the buttons, and so on. It describes how to fill the list by default so the user can create a configuration. And then it defines how to create a configuration by reading the input of the user from the UI. Then it defines how to run the configuration. And finally, if it allows or no MIDI doctor test to be available. Finally, you have the result. So the result define how to build the right tree from the plugin result object. And you can do that via Pragma. So I will show after how you do it. And it can define action that you can apply on the results via a command design pattern. So here is an example of how you can build a result tree via Pragma. You add the Pragma on a method of the result object. And so you can put an extension method, for example, if you need more visualization just for you. And then you just build the tree with the model objects for the tree that are provided by the doctor test. To define additional actions on the right tree, so when you right-click on the tree to get the contextual menu, we use Commander 2. And so you have a DSL to describe, okay, I want to add this command, and then you specify via the UI different parameters, for example, if you want to hide it or not, when it cannot be run according to the context, and so on. Okay, so I would like to say a word, so I don't know if you see well, this is me 6 months... So 6 months before at Faraday's, where I did a presentation about doctor test. And so I had this slide which explained what was our goals. And so after 6 months of devs, I can say that we have a prototype of doctor test that is working quite well, and we want to integrate it in Faro 8. And we are in a good way to implement more tools to handle tests in Faro. Okay, so what are the next steps? The first one is to provide a good Calypso integration. So Calypso is the browser of Faro, the code browser of Faro. With the configuration system, it should be easy because Calypso will just have to build a configuration object and give it to Doctor Test, and okay, it will be open on the right setting. And the next step also are to, because in the way that we implemented Doctor Test, we realized that some part of SUnit were not super easy to work with when you want to build tools over it. So there was some missing metadata on some part and so on. So we want to enhance SUnit and unify the API it exposes to the tools, to the graphical tools or command line tools and so on. And so on that direction, Damien already did some experiments with us, and we have some ideas on where to go next. So as a conclusion, Doctor Test will be part of Faro 8, and we will deprecate SUnit Runner, the UI of SUnit. And the new infrastructure will allow people to plug their own analysis, which we think is really important. Finally, I would like to say that tests are super valuable, and Doctor Test will help you to extract the gold that is hidden inside of your test. And so it opens a lot of possibilities for future tools around the test that you have. So, do you have any question?
Thank you very much for this wonderful presentation. I was wondering whether there is a way to plug a RoaSAL view on Dr. Test.
Yes.
Because we worked on a visual test coverage tool, and I was wondering there is some... So yes.
Yes, so we want that. We want to be able to control completely the UI from the plugin. And so from the result part, we would like, for example, to show a RoaSAL visualization or something like that. Mm.
Okay.
Thank so, you. Yes, this is in the plans.
So, are you planning to use this to run any sort of continuous integration test suite? Or just mainly being driven by the UI?
This is another objective. I did not list it, but we also want to rework the command line handler for exposing tests and create a new one that will use the Doctor Test model.
Okay.
So yes, this is one of the goals, is to expose the test through command line as well.
A link to that is any plans to be able to extract the stats and put them into some sort of time series database and see how things evolve over time?
So you mean keeping the history of the run of the test? Yeah. So because we created a model behind the UI, we are able to actually keep the result object and to store them to do further analysis later. So yes, it's possible.
Oh, my question was exactly the same, so
I okay. Would
what?
Okay.
Oh, good. There was one question.
Okay. Okay.
I was just wondering if you had any plans for integrating like quality tests into the view.
What?
Like, Faro has a quality assistant, right?
Yes.
Do you have plans to integrate quality, like a plugin for
quality
assistant?
Quality. Okay. Yeah, we would like also to integrate, because it would be just another plugin for Doctor Test. So yeah, it would be possible to integrate quality metrics in Doctor Test. Okay, thank you.